Welcome back, everyone. This is Radio Free Market, and I'm your host, Michael McKay, and with me, Dr. Thomas DiLorenzo. We've been talking about stateless but not lawless, the myths of the American West. And the last segment, we covered some rather disturbing information about how the U.S. actually engaged in very planned genocide against the American Indians. And Tom, I have to say, it's difficult to listen to this, but I think it's very important for us to actually get this information on the record and out among as many listeners as possible. But tell us about this Kiowa village attack in 1874.
Well, I used that in one of my publications as yet another example of what was going on during the so-called Indian Wars, where a Kiowa village was attacked, and they killed something like 1,000 horses that were there, and they captured several hundred of the Kiowas and put them in a dungeon in a military fort, and literally every once in a while, every day, threw some chunks of raw meat in, like they had wild animals living in there, and that's how they treated them, which was, I guess, better than they treated some of the other Indians, by just killing them outright.
Did some of the Indians actually try to escape?
Sure, they often try to escape, and who wouldn't?
Yeah, of course.
That sort of situation. The famous Crazy Horse, when he was captured, and after he was captured, he was murdered as a captive. And you may have heard of the famous book, Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee. The reason it has that title, and it was made into a movie also, is that after he was murdered, his parents were able to have his body, and so they cut out his heart and buried it where they thought no one would ever find it, on the Wounded Knee River. But it turns out there was another big Indian massacre right there at Wounded Knee where his heart was buried, and that's why that book had that title.
This culture of violence in our culture extended into our foreign policy over the next several decades as well.
It's one of the craziest things about American history, or the history of the government, is that the government claimed after the Civil War to be especially virtuous. You may have heard of the phrase American exceptionalism. So these same people that were perpetrating these acts of mass murder and genocide against the Plains Indians claimed to be the most virtuous people on earth, and they made the argument, and they still to this day, that by definition, just about anything they do is virtuous because they are so virtuous themselves. Teddy Roosevelt, when we were at war with the Filipinos, because we helped the Filipinos get rid of the Spanish Empire, but then the U.S. government wanted to make them part of the American Empire, and the Filipinos did not want to be a part of anyone's empire. They wanted independence. And so there was a war in which American military killed some 200,000 Filipinos, and Teddy Roosevelt justified it, using big quotation marks around the word justified, by calling the Filipinos savages and wild beasts, and dehumanizing them. And we have done that after that. During World War I, there was a huge demonization campaign against German Americans and everything German to justify American entry into World War I, which of course was disastrous. And so it's sort of the same template, the same strategy that went well into the 20th century that began in the Civil War years.
So we're going to close the show, folks, with a quick quote from Ludwig von Mises. He said, "What distinguishes man from animals is the insight into the advantages that can be derived from cooperation under the division of labor. Man curbs his innate instinct of aggression in order to cooperate with other human beings. The more he wants to improve his material well-being, the more he must expand the system of the division of labor. Concomitantly, he must more and more restrict the sphere in which he resorts to military action." So, Tom, I want to thank you very much for being with us today.
You're welcome, Michael.
So, folks, this is Michael McKay and Radio Free Market. Visit us on the web. We can download this and all of our shows for free. Check us out on iTunes, and please, wherever you are, please, stand up for freedom. Thank you for listening.